In this lecture, we are going to see some topics on aptitude, because aptitude plays a crucial role in every examination, whether it is regarding to government examinations or whether it is regarding to our campus placements. It plays a major role. So I thought of doing these videos will give you a better idea on aptitude. So friends, so let us start the aptitude lectures with probability friends. Not only probability, I'll teach you ages, averages, ratios and proportions, time and distance, mixtures and delegations, Bode's engines, everything friends. What are the concepts we are having in aptitude, those will be covered in these lectures with shortcuts friends. See friends, with very good shortcuts, I will use this, I will do the sums so that you can do any sum in a very short span of time. So I request you to be follow the lectures friends. So today we are going to start the topic with probability friends. So probability, before going to learn probability, we should learn permutation combinations friends. I thought that what I observed is, if you take two persons, one who knows the concept very well in probability, he will say that probability is very easy. If you take two person, if he tells that he don't know the concept in probability, he will say that it is very difficult. I think you have faced this in your career, I think, because what I faced is really this one, because I haven't learned the concept here, so that I used to feel the probability is so difficult. But friends, when you focus on shortcuts friends, really it will make sure that you can understand probability in a very easy manner. So initially going to learn about probability, let us start the concept with permutation combination, because permutation combinations plays a very good role for solving the problems in probability. So I think friends, you might have learned permutation combinations in your previous classes. So no matter how much in which stage you are, forget that and all, you just concentrate on this class, you can get a very clear idea on permutation combination. So friends, what is permutations and what is combinations? Have you ever got a doubt what is permutations and what is combinations? Friends, let us first get an example that I have four boxes, box 1, box 2, box 3, box 4. So I have four boxes friends, I'm having four boxes. What is the question I'm having now is, I should select two out of four boxes randomly. So what is the question I'm having now is, I have to select two out of these four boxes randomly. So what is the question? So what is my answer? I can pick up 1 2 2 3 3 4, correct friends? Whether it is correct or not, I can take 1 2 1 3 1 4, 1 2 2 3 3 4. I can select any two boxes out of four boxes. So this may be the this is correct or not. I can take this which is called combination friends. If we go for only required probability, then we'll call it as combination. I think you got the point. If we go for only our required probability, then it is combination. Then what is permutation friends? Permutation is all possible combinations. What is all possible combination friends? Initially I'll take box 1. So with this I'll take combination as 2, as 3, as 4, right? Or it may, I can take 2, and for this combination I'll take 1, 3, 4. I'll take 3. 3 is common of the box. I can take 1, 2, 4. I'll take box 4 as common. I can take 1, 2, 3. Have we got the point? So, these are all the possibles. These are all the possibles. I'm correct or not? These are all the possibles which I can take. Combination means only required probability. So, what is the question they ask? We have to select 2 out of 4 boxes randomly. So, I have selected 2 out of 4 boxes randomly, which is the combination. But permutation means it is all the combinations. All the combination. This is only certain combination. This is only certain combination. These are all the combinations. So, selecting of all the combinations is called permutation. Selecting of only required probability is called permutation. I think you got the point now. Right, friends? So, friends, in your previous classes, you have learned some formulas like NPR, NCR. You might learn, but what I teach in this lectures is I won't use any formulas here. Never. I never use any formulas here. I'll go only by shortcuts, which can make you do the sum in a very short span of time. Trust me, you can do it very well. So, friends, go with the concept. So, friends, let us take an we go through the and one example. Let us take an example there. In a shelf, not a shelf. You'll take this as a cupboard. In a cupboard, there are three shirts. Shirt 1, shirt 2, shirt 3, and 2 pants. In a cupboard, there are 3 shirts and 2 pants. So, I am having a question that what is the probability of in how many ways I can choose either shirt or pant? Friends, this is the question. I'm having 3 shirts and 2 pants in a cupboard. I'm having a question that in how many ways either a shirt or pant can be taken randomly? In how many ways? See, friends, initially how many shirts are there? 3 shirts are there. I'm correct or not? How many pants are there? 2 pants are there. So, 3 shirts and 2 pants. I can take any one of the shirt from 3 shirts, or I can take any one of the pant from 2 pants. I'm correct or not? So, the total number of ways that I can choose either shirt or pant is 3 plus 2. I'm correct or not? I can take 1 shirt from this, or I can take 1 pant from this. Whenever you get R in probability or in permutation, you just use the symbol plus, friends. I think you get the point. Next question is, what is the how many number of ways can a shirt and a pant can taken together? Can taken together. Friends, this is a nice question. In how many ways both shirt and pant can take together? In how many ways? Friends, you just pause the videos and you do on it in home and you verify whether you are doing correct or not. No matter if you do wrong, just you do the concept. Friends, see, he asked that what is the number of ways that a shirt and a pant can take together. So, friends, let me see. I can take this shirt. Yes, friends, I can take this shirt, and with this shirt I can take this two pant, this pant and this pant. Correct or not? This pant and this pant. For this, I will take shirt 2. I can take this pant and this pant. For this shirt, it is having 2 ways. And for this shirt also, it is having 2 ways. For this shirt also, it is having 2 ways. So, how many total ways? Yes, friends. I think you are getting the point. So, for this shirt, it may be this pant or this pant. For this shirt, this may be. It may be this pant or this pant. For this shirt, it may be of any 2 parts. I think you get the point. So, what is the question they ask? In how many ways both shirt and pant can take together? That's simply 3 into 2. Correct or not? 6 ways. This is 5 ways. This is 6 ways. For 3 shirts, I'm having 2 pants. I can take this shirt. For this one, I can take any one of this pant. For this shirt, I can take any one of this pant. For this shirt, I can take any one of the pant. Correct or not? So that is the reason that 3 into 2. And one important note, this whenever you get and in probability or permutation and combination, you just put it as into friends. This is the best way so that you can understand in an easy manner. So now we are going to take a node point. Friends, what is the node point here? Event A, if event A can be done in m ways, let event A can be done in n ways, let event B can be done in n ways, what are the number of ways either A or B? So what friends, what I told, if we get any or, we just use plus, correct or not? So what are the number of ways? M plus n ways. Remember this friends, it is very useful. If they ask both A and B, what is the answer? Both A and B, it is M into n ways. Friends, I think you got the concept very well. If you have any doubts, you just contact me. So this is one of the basic thing which we should learn for the basics of permutation and combination. So now friends, let us go through one example so that you can get a clear idea on this one. I'm having some questions which are very useful to us. So friends, see this. See friends, what is the question he asked? A box with 6 vertical strips has to be designed using colors red, black, green, white, yellow. In how many ways can this be done if no two adjacent strips are of same color? Friends, what he asked? A box with 6 vertical strips. So I should draw 6 vertical strips box. I am going to draw 6 vertical strips. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So these are the 6 vertical strips. What he told has to be designed using colors red, black, green, white, yellow. In how many ways can this be done if no two adjacent strips are of same color? See friends, what is stunning now that if we take this as red, we should not get red here. This is the concept what he given. See, no two adjacent strips are of same color. What he given here is, see, if I take red here, we should not take red here. So that how many number of ways can be, in how many ways can the color can be arranged, he has asked me. So friends, let me take. So what are the number of colors I'm having? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For the first box, I can fill with red or black or green or white or yellow. Whether I'm doing correct or not, friends. I can fill it with red, black, green, yellow and white. So I can fill box 1 with 5 colors. Not with 5 colors. In any one from 5 colors. Let I'm filling the box 1 with red color. So what is the number of ways the box is having? It is having 5 ways. Yes or no friends? It is having 5 ways. I'm correct or not friends? Now get to box number 2. See friends, in box number 2 already it is filled. I'm correct or not? Already it is filled. Filled with which color? Red color. So that I should not get red here. So out of these 5 colors, one color is gone. So how many colors I'm having? 4 colors. In 4 colors I may take black or green or white or yellow. Let we take it as black. So what is the number of chances that box 2 is having? It is having 4 chances. I'm correct or not? So now I should not take black here. Correct or not? I should not take this black here. So that I can take red. Why? Because these are not two adjacent sides, na? These two are adjacent sides, but these two are not adjacent sides. So I can take red here. So black is not having chances here. So this box, how many ways it is having? It is having in 4 ways. So for this box also I am having 4 ways. This box is also having 4 ways. This box is also having 4 ways. So what is the number of ways? 5 into 4 power 5 ways. Friends, I think you got the point. very well. Friends, I think you got it. If you have any question, you can contact me. Friends, there are some important points which should be covered by us. Let us take an example there. Friends, we'll stop this session. Friends, we'll stop this session up to here. We'll continue the next concept and next question in the next lecture videos. I hope that you got the point very well. Thank you, friends.